Always on fire. You watch him go. Hello guys, welcome back to an episode of Minecraft. Oh man, he left. He was sitting there. Fred was just watching this zombie, man. He was just standing there like teasing the guy like, fuck you, I'm in a safe village, what you gonna do now? Oh, these guys, they're crazy. They're still not having sex there. Maybe they're fighting. Maybe Noah's mad that Fred changed his dreams and became a cook. I don't know. It's hard to say. First thing I'm going to do today is make some iron golems. So I'm going to go ahead and go get the materials for that. And I'll be back with you guys. I just wanted to show you Fred being a dick and teasing the zombie. But it looks like he's done with that. So now he's going to go right here and tease Noah Mark II. Look at me. I'm free, motherfucker. Go trample some wheat. Yeah, I'm watching you. I see you. All right, guys. I'm back over here, and I don't know what happened to Noah. I'm trying to find him. I cannot. All I did was go over and. Oh, I think it's him in there. Let's see. All I did was go over there. Yeah, there he is. Okay. All is well. Maybe Noah and Fred are having their first squirrel as a couple. So I've never built one of these before, so I feel the need. It's raining watermelon. Yeah, I feel the need to do this on camera, just because I've never done it before. Well, that was fun. He kind of looks bored. Is he moonwalking? Shut up, pause. I think the other thing I'm going to work on today is getting the light switch thing based on daytime to work. I'm going to build a couple of these guys just so there's plenty of them around. And I'm assuming they'll walk around on their own, but go ahead and kind of space them out a little bit. See, look at that zombie in here. Maybe this guy will see him and defend the village's honor. Go, defend it. Worthless bastard. Oh, don't trample those crops. Paws is defending. Paws got the zombie got the first hit off of Paws. I think I'll build one more of these guys. All right, you big nose bastard. Let's keep this place safe. Alright, I'll be back with you guys. Hey again, guys. So I want to update on you some... update you... What? Update you guys on some things. First thing is these freaking guys here, man. That's all they've done. They've just sat there inside of this deck here. Like they're grilling out. This ain't the South, motherfuckers. You got people to protect. Look at that. There's a spider in here. What the fuck are you doing? That spider wants his villagers. Why is there no sound? Oh, I bet my, oh yeah, there was sound. It just wasn't sound for me. Alright, so I've made our power station, and I didn't make it inside of the village, because I want it to be, see it's outside here, I want it to be something that looks like a power station or something, at least a tower of some sorts. So there it is. You can see right now, there's a repeater right there. Right now the way it's set up is at nighttime, and this is the default of it, that nighttime it's not powered. I'll just have to invert that. But I purposely started recording while it was nighttime, just so I could show you that it was in the off position. And we will sleep here, and we'll just kind of see how quick it updates. It seems to be fairly quick. Right now I'm the only one on, so luckily we can sleep and do this little test here. Get around here. And as you see, it's already updated. The grass has already grown. And now that repeater there is in the own state. Make sure there's nobody around here, and I'll go ahead and show you guys this. I mean, I can't take any credit for it. It was made by JL Zip Code. it's JL2579 or something like that. I will put a link to his video that shows how to make this in the description, just so you guys can make it as well. I take no credit whatsoever for making any of this. But here's how it works. If I can even get, I don't think I can even get back up the top now that I filled it in with dirt. No. Alright, so right down there is where the grass grows at. Whenever the grass grows, it's just using a bud switch to do a block update. So whenever the grass grows, it's sitting right there. That's it. So whenever that grass grows, block updates, and pistons move out, cuts off the power here. So that's pretty much as simple as it is. The more of these you have, the quicker it will update. Basically, each of these, you really only need one of these that I have here. This whole setup, it could be done with just one block of grass and one bud switch here. But if you have multiple ones, then the moment any of these update, it updates. So that's why it's so quick. So there's that. Again, I wanted this to be kind of like a little power station here, so that's why I've built it up on this platform instead of it just being, you know, underground where you can't see it or whatever. Plus, it's closer to the sun, so it's going to update quicker, right? No, I don't think that's how it works. Some updates. I know you guys have wondered what happened to the iPhone and Android apps. Nothing happened to them. They were in work and development. Some of it was waiting on... there's some server-related things that I've been working on, and so she was waiting on me to do some of the stuff that was necessary for database connectivity for the apps and stuff like that. But all of that's done now. I just got done paying Apple and the Android market for developer access so that we could upload everything to iTunes and the Android market, respectively. So everything's pretty much done, ready to go. Just waiting on approval from those markets in order for the apps to be available. There won't be any cost for them. It only costs me, let's see, it's $100, well, after tax, it's like $107 to Apple and then $25 to Android. So that was the cost to me to make that stuff available for you guys. It's nothing like the $3,000 I paid for bandwidth. It's funny, had some guy complain on the last video about the map not being up, and he didn't even take a constructive approach to complaining, so add that to another guy on the block list. He said something along the lines, he's gonna, you know, unsubscribe and dislike all the videos until the maps are available for download again, because I need to stop being lazy. So yes, just a reminder, bandwidth over usage, $3,000, that's what it cost me for the month of May. So yes, that's why the map is down. For anyone that missed that episode where I talked about it, I will not be spending thousands and thousands of dollars so you guys can download the map every month. But eventually I will work on a solution, if nothing else, a torrent for you guys so that you can download the map. But that's the update on those things. I'm going to continue working here. I think I'm going to go visit Shree's house and see how many slimes he has available, because apparently he's got a really good slime farm. So we shall see. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do here. I might not do it this episode as far as encasing this thing here. I might wait and see what you guys think. At first I was thinking kind of like a nuclear reactor, or not the reactor, the steam vents for a nuclear reactor. But I'm probably just as bad as B00 at making circles, so I don't know if I'll do that or not. We'll just have to wait and see. There's some other things I was going to update you guys on, but I'll have to think about that while I work on some stuff and I'll take some notes. I'm not going to just have the pistons through here that this is being used for. Now that I have that, I really want to use it for lots of things inside of this village. I don't even know what all yet, but I'll work that out as we go along here. I was thinking about lining some redstone lamps down the sides of the walkway here, just to come on at night. I don't know. We'll figure that out as we go along. And these worthless guys, man. Here's the thing. There's two of those, right? And I made four total. You know where the other two are at? There they are. They can get out, too. It's like, here's a walkway. Come on out. They just like it down there. Fucking guys. So, anyways, I'll be back with you guys. Hey again, guys. This is going to be a one hell of a mismatch of an episode, because it's taken me, I think it's over 5 days that I've recorded this, and I don't remember everything I've talked about so far. But I'm going to kind of wrap it up here. I said 13 minutes or so of video so far, so... what I've done, just in some spare time the other night, is I've started extending these bricks out this way, and we come up around here, tied it in with this road here, and I got it all the way up and around over here, and I ran out of bricks. I didn't cook them all the other day, so I just went back and I cooked what I had left, and... this is all the bricks I have left. Now, I know that there's some in the arena still I can grab. And there's also still some clay inside of B00's house. And I asked him if he minded if I cleaned up his house some and took the clay. And he does not mind, so I will be doing that as well. Let's see here. Do I have any chest? Damn it. Keep running out of chest room in here. I really want to make a storage area over here, because I keep bringing more and more stuff over here. But what I'm about to do now is I'm going to make my journey over to the desert. That's not what I mean at all. My head is all clouded. I'm still on these freaking painkillers for 6 more days, and it's really affected my ability to be a human being. I don't know how people, like, I had some friends in my life that were these big pill heads, and I don't know how people function constantly taking pills. But whatever. Okay. There's a couple things I want to talk about too, but I'm going to wait till it's daytime to continue recording. Looking at the moon just reminded me of something. If you guys haven't checked out Milby, I have to admit, I never had watched any of Milby's stuff. I'd seen him in a couple of Paul's live streams, but I never really knew how funny the guy is. His Minecraft videos have been hilarious. And people complain, I mean, kind of like same thing that happened to Zisto. People complained about his texture pack, and people have done the same thing to Milby. And so Milby fired up a Matt Damon texture pack for his episode 3, and man, that was some of the funniest shit I've ever seen. And he plays it off so well. He just doesn't even acknowledge the fact that he's using this retarded Matt Damon texture pack. He's just Matt Damon everywhere. The moon is just Matt Damon. The moon's coming up, and he's like, "Oh, I think that's a full Damon. I'm not really sure. Kurt would know, though." Just, I don't know, man. That should crack me up. Anyways, I'm going to walk out to the desert and... fuck, the desert. Why do I keep saying the desert? The jungle over there. And I'm going to get some saplings. And I will probably record over there and talk to you guys some about some of the things that I've been thinking about. Talking about. I'll be back. This fucking placement of this workbench is the worst. I don't know what I was thinking. There's no way to get back into it now, though. It's impossible. Can't be done. There's no way to not hit the hitbox of one of these. Oh, yep, I've ruined it. Ruined it. I have to make another workbench now. Damn it, man. Yeah, I just had to share that because it's retarded of me. Alright, so I've made it to the jungle. I didn't realize how close the jungle was. I remembered it being kind of close, but it took like 30 seconds to walk over here. I could have just kept recording. So yeah, I want to get some saplings more than anything here. But figured now would be a good time to just story time. The other day on the video for the mailbox stuff, people were talking about currency, and it was kind of weird because my wife and I recently had a conversation because my whole, you know, my car, my key for my car, for those that have seen that Minecraft episode where I showed off the new car, it uses RFID. In order to work, basically whenever somebody was talking about currency, I said that I'd be a fan of going to an RFID transaction based system, and a lot of people were saying that that's insecure, and I'd like for people to do a little bit of research on RFID and see where it's being used currently. One of the places that it's currently being used is in casinos in the United States. Pretty much every casino in Vegas, at least. I'm not certain about Atlantic City, but I know for sure in Vegas, pretty much every casino now uses RFID inside of the chips, the gambling chips, and they've been doing that since 2005. I think the Wynn or Bellagio one was the first ever to go over to that system. Being stingy as hell with the saplings, isn't it? Saplings. So I said that weird, I think. So I think the security aspect of it has been pretty highly tested. I mean, Vegas itself is a multi-billion-dollar area. I don't know if you I don't know if you can call a city an industry. It basically is, though. So I believe that for the uses it's been that it's been used in. It's been basically tested and has been very secure. I know in 2010 there was a big robbery at, I think it was Bellagio. You can YouTube it. You can actually see the footage of the guy coming in to the casino in a motorcycle helmet. He took over $1 million in chips from a craps table. And the moment he left that casino, those chips became worthless because they were using RFID tracking on the chips, and all the chips he stole were worth absolutely nothing. So I don't know. I think RFID has come a long ways from where it was originally talked about. And honestly, I think one of the things now, I hate to go this direction with what I'm about to talk about, but I think one of the biggest things that's stopping it from being used in humans is religion, because the whole Mark of the Beast and mess like that. I think a lot of people are afraid. I don't think it should be. I think eventually it will become mandatory that if it's not RFID, it will be some other type of technology that's implanted in people when they're born that will track them. And I'm completely for that. I know some people, you know, are afraid and they don't want the government in their life and all this mess. But man, the benefits are just overwhelming. The things that you could do with this type of technology, for instance, going back to my car. You know, my car starts, my doors unlock, etc. whenever I'm near my car, because my key has the RFID in it. So it knows that I'm here. It will now accept me for who I am, and it will let me in. Damn it. Here we go. And really, to me, there should be no keys. I mean, whenever you buy a car, it's just like your social security number. And for those that don't live in America, the social security number is just a tracking. I'm sure most people know, but just in case you don't, it's just, you know, a simple number that's assigned to you upon birth, and it's used to track you throughout your life, or credit, etc. But I think that the next step with that would be something that's implanted in the person. And it doesn't necessarily have to be implanted in the same exact spot on every person. One thing, when my wife and I were discussing this, she said, you know, if it was like in your hand or something, people could just chop off people's hands. And, but, I mean, that's going to an extreme, too. Because we were talking about, again, talking about my whole car, how it unlocks itself whenever you're in range of it. Or not within range, whenever you put your hand on the door, if you have the key within range. The same thing could be done at your house. You know, you walk up to your house and you got your hands full with your groceries and stuff like that, and the door just says like, hey, it's Jason, and the door, you know, unlocks whenever you touch it. I would love something like that on my house. And it may sound lazy or something. It's not about being lazy. It's about being badass. Dude, whenever my door can unlock itself because it knows I'm here, that shit's badass. I don't care what anyone says. Like, whenever they show me that on my car, I mean, I'd already bought the car, but I was like, I will give you more money now. Like, it's just so, I don't know. To me, it's just cool. So, yeah, that's my spew on RFID. I really think that it has a lot of positive implementations. And I think that that's one of the things that I think really the only thing that's stopping its further development in human use is religion more than anything. So I wish that things like that weren't the case. It's unfortunate that technological advances are being slowed down because of silly things like that. What else was I going to talk about? I told you guys that check out Milby. And, you know, the people on the server, sometimes some people go unnoticed, I guess. It's kind of funny, Milby passed a couple people on the server in subs the first day he was on the server. When he joined the server, he had 2,700 subs, and when I checked earlier, he's almost at 10,000 now. So in like 2 days, he's gained, you know, over 7,000 subs, or almost 7,000 subs, which is just crazy to me. I mean, as the server progresses, I'm still not realizing. Someone said you can grab these with Silk Touch now. It's a damn lie. Can't be done. Maybe it's a 1.3. As the server progresses, I still haven't realized where we're at and what, and I don't know, the level of excitement and following that people have for the server and each new person that joins. I mean, I know, like, whenever Beef joined, he only had around 200 subs or so. Man, he's grown a lot since then. Same thing with Paws, but I don't know. It's just weird. Then you got guys like Michael. Other spare stationers in another free form. Like, Michael, he's been on the server for quite some time, and maybe we passed him in subs in the first day. But I think some of it's, The people's dedication to the server, but also the personalities and what the viewer's looking for. I know for me, like I said before, I didn't really know much about Milby, and the first day just watch his videos, man. I haven't laughed that hard, and I don't know when. So I didn't realize what I was missing out on, and I think that's what some of it is. Some people, you know, they're looking for a certain type of personality. They're not just subbing because they're on the server. I think that can be seen with how many subs some people have versus others. But I think that's what's so great about the server is the ability to provide people with multiple different personalities. I guess I end up with some leaves somehow. So that, you know, depending on what you're looking for, you can find it on the server. Need to grow lots of these. I think, what color does that, what's that wood look like whenever it's broken down? That's the reddish wood. Well, what the hell does, what's pine tree look like? You know, honestly, it's really strange, but I haven't taken the time to look at all these since they got added. I wish Milby wasn't on right now. I would like to sleep. Let's talk about what a great guy he is, but I really wish he'd get the fuck out for the moment. Oh, man. You know, I don't know how Paul's or anyone for that matter, runs around at night in ultra hardcore. Shit blows my mind. Because, I mean, just the other day I was on here and I was, just gonna grab one of these real quick, just because I want to see what it looks like. Give me two. I was running around and I kept trying to avoid skeletons, man. I kept getting my ass handed to me. I don't see one right now, so I'm safe. But, yeah. Running around at night in ultra hardcore does not seem wise. You know, one thing about Paul's, I was thinking about this earlier. I was watching his 1 year anniversary video and he was talking about how he got on the server and stuff like that. And I was thinking about when I used to watch him, or when I first was watching him. Fuck me. No, don't get in, zombie. Don't do it. And that was close. I might have died. When I was first watching him do that 404 map that I'd made, that's what got me interested in asking him to join the server, just because of the way he played. Oh, it's really dark. I haven't seen that. Let's look at that. Oh man, I like that. I really like that. I'm gonna have to do something with that too. What does this wood over here look? Get this back. But yeah, and what I was gonna say about Paul is if you guys go watch him do my 404 map, the thing that attracted me to him was how fucking bad he is at the game. So what I don't understand is how does he perform so well sometimes in the ultra hardcore? Whenever, if you go watch, man, it wasn't that long ago that he was doing the 404 map, and he sucked ass. Like, for real. Really bad. Like, not even kind of bad. Like, so terrible that it was hilarious. Those look kind of cool together. I don't know what I can do with them yet, but I definitely want to use this for the storage area up here. So yeah, if you haven't watched Paul's do my 404 map, I recommend watching at least some of it, just to see how fucking terrible he was at the game. It's just mind-boggling. And then to see him perform well in Ultra Hardcore, I don't know, man. I don't get it. Did he just find a box of skill and put it on or something? was he trolling whenever he was doing my map, and he was actually good at the game, and he just pretended? Like, what's the deal? What's the deal, Paws? Tell us the deal. Well, anyways, I think that pretty much sums up my episode for today. I'd like to know what you guys... What was that sound? Earlier I was checking on these guys and they weren't together anymore. I think they may have had a lover's quarrel. Yeah, look at them. They each got their own house now. It's alright, guys. And I do realize that I need some more doors in this area in order to get them to breed. I don't want to build a box of doors to facilitate a bunch of breeding. I would like for this to be a little bit more natural. I don't want to flood the area with villagers. I want them to breed naturally. So I'm going to be building more houses and getting some more doors in here and a natural setting to allow them to breed. But I just don't want to spam the place with it. But yeah, I'd like to get some ideas from you guys about what you think up here. Where I'm leaning right now is to do kind of like the steam stacks from a nuclear power station. But if you guys have a better idea or something you'd like to see, then feel free to submit it and we'll see where we end up with that. But as always, I appreciate you guys watching, and I will see you all next time.
Always on fire. You watch him go on the fence. You watch him go on the fence. You watch him go on the fence. Find just a scene as life got you laughing every night. Yes. Do you know your diamond shit just got fucked. The way things explode out of them from all sides.